I'm in Algonquin Park on day one of a 6-day canoe trip, and I've started off on Lake Opiongo and I ventured off into a large wetland area that I'm exploring, Hailstorm Creek. I've been paddling through this wetland for over an hour now, and it never seems to end. It's just immense. It goes on forever. All right, just made it to my first portage for the day, 2 kilometers. All right, beauty. Just arrived on this beautiful beach, the end of a 2200 meter portage into Happy Isle Lake. What a beautiful day. I've stayed on this site before. It's a great site. Not today though, gotta push on. Alright, let's check it out. Awesome beach. This water's so warm. Look at this. Pretty big clam. All right, so I'll give you a quick look at my route before I lose the light. So this morning I started at Opiongo. I actually took the water taxi all the way up to the north arm of Opiongo, and I was dropped off here at Hailstorm Bay. So that saved me almost 3 hours of paddling this morning. That allowed me to explore Hailstorm Creek in here. I went quite deep into the creek, spent an hour and a half, maybe 2 hours paddling through here. I doubled back, took the 2200 meter portage into Happy Isle Lake, another portage into Merchant, and I'm camped here tonight. Great first day, beautiful weather, nice sandy beach, great start to the trip. Cliff bars for breakfast, coffee, and then once I'm ready, short little paddle to the portage, 1800 meters into Big Trout Lake. All right, ready to go. Thank you. Wow. Big Trout Lake is dead calm. So serene. Well, I'm really spoiled for choice here. I've only seen a single tent on all of Big Trout Lake. It's the last week of August. It's Monday, so maybe that's it. But it's nice to be able to have my pick of pretty much any campsite I choose. So I'm gonna check out this island now. Looks nice. Well, the views are incredible right off the bat. Goes up. Oh wow, looking very promising. Wow, oh, gorgeous views. Smells like pine needles drying in the sun. And wow, very well built fire area. Wow, that's incredible. This site keeps on going. Have a look at this. Up. Wow. Look at that view. Wow. There's an island here. And lots to explore. It's a long walk back to the water, but definitely worth it. Look at this. Look at this water. Can't wait to go for a swim right here. And tomorrow, I'll be heading right over there, right down there, for my portage. couldn't resist going for a paddle. It's a beautiful evening. I ate quite a bit today, so all I'm having for dinner are some creamy mashed potatoes, some pepperoni, and a special surprise, special treat for dessert, Wonder Bar. Stunning morning today. Coffee and granola for breakfast.
Had a wonderful night at that beautiful campsite, but I have a fair amount of distance to cover today, at minimum 23 kilometers, so I'm on the water early, just past 9 a.m.
This is my third day out here. It's the end of August, and after leaving Lake Opiongo on day one, I haven't seen a single paddler, which is incredible. Small rapids here. I think I'm gonna run it. Lake Lemure. It's a bit of a hazy day. Rain might be in the forecast for later tonight. We'll see. Curious to have a look at this campsite. It's not a bad little site, but gotta push on. Wow, I just saw a black bear. As I was coming forward, I saw some bushes rustling. I knew there was something in there. And as I approached, all I could see is his ears. And then he stood up a little bit. He looked at me a few times, and then he took off. Very cool. The bear was right in here. You can see a lot of flowers. Probably a lot of berries as well. Oh man, the mosquitoes are absolutely brutal at that takeout. Wow, this is very cool. Massive cliff. Beautiful. The lake is glass, so using this opportunity to head down to the far end of it. Rain started. Still got a bit to go before I get to my campsite. The rain seems to have stopped, and I've reached Parks Bay at the far east end of Hogan Lake. And I see a site right now, this direction, that looks really nice.
This looks promising. I just need to figure out how to get up there. Here's the takeout. Nice. This is the upper area. And I can already tell there's a stunning view here. Incredible. Wow. Cozy, intimate site with a stunning view, far away from anyone else. This is my kind of site. Amazing. You can definitely dive off these cliffs, but the issue is, how do you get back up?
Hey, buddy. How's the fishing?
I hope the rain holds off so I can make the most of this evening, enjoy a nice fire here, and this incredible view. Stunning. Makes the 30 kilometers I traveled today worth it for sure. So I covered almost 30 kilometers today, left Big Trout this morning, went up this way, Burnt Root, Lake Lemure, saw a bear around here, then into Hogan, past all these campsites. This is a big lake. My map doesn't even show the end of it. I'm at the very end, camped on this secret, amazing, secluded campsite. So if you want to find it, you'll have to make your way up here and discover it yourself. Making myself a double hot chocolate. Oh yeah, extra chocolatey goodness. Alpine Air spicy sausage pasta for dinner. That is hot.
rain through the night. Hopefully it ends soon.
Well, I absolutely love this campsite, but it's time for me to go now, get back on the water. 11 a.m. Bit misty still, but rain seems to have stopped. Gonna miss this campsite, but I'll be back one day. Next stop, Big Crow Lake.
It's definitely picked up today. Whoa, that's a strong tailwind on the lee side here.
One thing with this canoe is, in a strong tailwind, sometimes it feels like the back end wants to get pushed around, it wants to turn you. Otherwise, it's a great canoe.
Here we go.
Goes way up, right off the bat.
There we go. All right. Now, time to find a campsite.
Oh yeah, baby. Look at this.
I always wanted to stay at this site. I finally get to check it out. It looks really nice.
This site is massive. Look at this fire pit area. Wow, there's a wind block here. Previous campers were nice enough to leave some wood. Oh, first time I see the sun today, literally just now. Sorry for the wind noise. Look at this view. Wow. table. My campsite has a very nice fire pit area. I'd much rather have a small fire here out on the beach. Just enjoy this view. I'm not the first to do so. I saw some burnt firewood right beside me, but I'm gonna make absolutely certain that there's no trace of this fire tomorrow when I leave. What a perfect evening. Cozy little fire. Still, loons have been calling. Beautiful beach. Amazing day. Really couldn't ask for more. I'm feeling very grateful right now. Just happy to be alive. Got really cold last night. Definitely dipped down into the single digits, probably the low single digits. Bone chilling. I absolutely love this breakfast granola that I made myself. Gotta credit John from Lost Lakes for the inspiration. Not a trace. And a gorgeous morning. Back on Opiongo. It's one massive lake.
Well, I'm gonna put my good camera away because it's getting a bit dicey out there and I just don't want to risk it. The campsite that I was aiming for was taken, unfortunately, so I have to make my way further down the lake.
Oof.
Boy, am I glad to get off the water. I'll take this. I'll take it. Oh boy. Whew.
Well, this will have to do. It's a massive, massive campsite. I made the right call to get off the water because it's howling out there. There are some strong gusts.
I think it's time to take a little nap. I was just walking along the beach here and I noticed this little stream. The water coming out of it is extremely frigid and it's tea stained. As you can see, it's blending with the lake water here that's clear. Very cool.
Figure I go for one last paddle. It's my final night. The lake is finally calm. Just enjoy some of the serenity. What a magnificent evening. Beautiful sunset to cap off an amazing trip. Couldn't have asked for more.
Don't expect being up too late tonight. Gonna enjoy the fire for a bit and then head to bed because it's gonna be an early morning.
Gorgeous morning out here.
I made it about halfway down the lake. Gonna stretch my legs for a bit.
Beauty sight.
Well, I think I'm gonna wrap things up here. Should be at the access in about an hour or so. Overall, this was a fantastic trip. Really was blessed with beautiful weather, bear encounter, amazing sights. Fantastic trip, and looking forward to the next one.
Made it.